Between the dates of May 14th and June 14th of this year, Star Wars Battlefront 2 has gained over 3 million new players. This brings the total player count up to about 14 million players worldwide. These numbers come directly from Gamstat.com, which is an unofficial source, and although they're not affiliated with Sony, they do take real-time data from the PlayStation Network to calculate actual figures. These calculations are usually very accurate, with a margin of error of about plus or minus 10%, which is pretty good. 3 million new players coming to Battlefront 2 means that the game has gained more than 30% of its total player base in just the span of a month. This should not come as much of a surprise, because Battlefront 2 went up for free on both the PlayStation Network and Steam in the month of June, which definitely contributed to the high spike of new players coming to the game. Back in April, it was reported that Battlefront 2 had only 8 million active players total, which means that between then and now, Battlefront 2 has increased its player base by just about 50%. This is actually pretty ridiculous when you consider the fact that when Battlefront 2 launched, it only sold roughly between 9 and 11 million copies. The 3 million new players coming to the game means that Battlefront 2 has added a third of its launch figures to the total player base in just under 1 month. We're not even through the month of June yet, we still have another week and a half to go, which means that these numbers are only going to go up, especially on the PlayStation Network and Steam. I'm going to be very interested to see what the new player count looks like between June 1st and July 1st, once Battlefront 2 is no longer available for free. So, why do I bring any of this up? Well, the TLDR is that these figures go to show that Battlefront 2's popularity has only gone up since release, and it really makes me question EA's decision to cancel content support for Battlefront 2, when right now everything seems to be going pretty well for the game. With what was probably the biggest controversy in gaming history following it around for 2.5 years, it's kind of a miracle that it survived that long, and even more of a miracle that the player base has not only stuck around, but the player numbers have gone up. This game is gaining more and more popularity every single day, and even the word of mouth has become more positive in recent times. So many news outlets are putting out headlines and articles talking about how fun of an experience Battlefront 2 is, and how it definitely had a redemption story, and it's nothing like the game that we had at launch. Even the petition that is asking EA to make more content updates for Battlefront 2 has been making a lot of headlines, and is now closing in on 100,000 signatures. As of recording this video, it's sitting at just about 96,000, so if you want to add your name to the list and get it up to 100K, I'll have it linked below in the description. All of this is good, positive press, and positive press is something that EA really needs right now. Currently, the only Star Wars game that EA is still giving regular content updates to is Galaxy of Heroes, the mobile game. And if you've been staying in the loop with what's happening with Galaxy of Heroes right now, you know that there is a serious controversy happening between the game developer and the content creators who make videos on it. We have the top content creators for that game almost literally boycotting it, which is not a good look for the only remaining live service Star Wars title that EA is in charge of. That's bad press, and I'm sure they're pretty used to it by now, but that's still not something that EA wants. With that said, it's now conspiracy theory tinfoil hat time. I do find it a little bit weird that the interest in the Galaxy of Heroes controversy seemed to die down a little bit after the leak for Squadrons. Even more so after the official trailer reveal and the gameplay reveal. If you recall, the official name and the artwork for Squadrons was leaked on PlayStation Network a couple of days ahead of the reveal trailer. I can't be 100% certain, but part of me really feels like EA wanted that to leak a couple of days early so that it could get people's minds off of the Galaxy of Heroes controversy. And to a certain extent, I think it worked. It definitely took a lot of eyes off of the Galaxy of Heroes controversy, but it also opened up a bit of a can of worms in and of itself. The reveal for Star Wars Squadrons demonstrated that Battlefront 2 is still the most popular Star Wars game that EA has. The reception to Squadrons' reveal was more or less positive, but you just did not feel that same amount of hype that you felt with Battlefront. You can also look at any social media posts made by EA Star Wars. The ones that are about Battlefront 2 absolutely destroy all the other ones in terms of engagement. More people like, retweet, comment on all the posts that have to do with Battlefront 2 more than any other Star Wars game under EA. In fact, on the posts that do talk about other Star Wars games, you get endless comments and tweets asking CT when or when's the next Battlefront update. And seeing that is just kind of bittersweet knowing that the content updates for Battlefront 2 are over. People clearly love this game. They clearly want more of it. We have millions upon millions of new players flocking to this game. In fact, 3 million in this month alone. And check this out. In this month, everybody got Battlefront 2 for free. This means that they got the base game for free, not the Celebration Edition. They can still upgrade to the Celebration Edition for, I think, like 25 bucks or something like that. And if they do, that is revenue directly into EA's pockets. Every single Celebration Edition upgrade is extra revenue that EA gets from a free game. This is basically the exact same thing as putting out DLC for the game and having people just pay a little bit extra money to get that DLC. What if this is just a trial run by EA? Put the game out for free, see how many people are interested in it, and see, at the end of the day, how many people upgrade to the Celebration Edition. If they get enough upgrades, that could tell EA that putting out future DLC for Battlefront 2 is in fact a good idea, and it's worth it, especially with all these new players coming to the game. 3 million brand new players is not small, and I'm sure that has caught EA's attention, especially considering that this all happened in less than a month. The GamStat figures showed between the dates of May 14th and June 14th, but keep in mind that Battlefront 2 did not go up for free on Steam or PSN until the beginning of June. So what we're basically looking at is 3 million new players in just under 3 weeks, 20 days. That is extremely impressive for a 2.5-year-old game that had an absolutely botched launch. Now, I totally understand why EA canceled Battlefront 2's content updates. They want to compete with Activision and whatever the next Call of Duty title is going to be. DICE is the development studio that actually made Battlefront 2. EA just publishes the physical copies and handles the business side of things. DICE is the entity that physically makes the game. DICE also works on the Battlefield franchise, which is a direct competitor to Call of Duty. EA's idea is to take everybody off of Battlefront 2, put all hands on deck on Battlefield 2021, whatever that title is going to be called, and make that the best possible game it can be so it can compete with the next Call of Duty game. They're basically throwing Battlefront 2 under the bus to compete with Activision and Call of Duty, and that is a shame, especially to us Star Wars fans. I also understand that Battlefield is the flagship franchise for DICE. That is their biggest franchise, the most games that they've put out. They're probably most well known for Battlefield. I get that. I respect that. On the other hand, I also think that DICE could be better known for working on the Battlefront franchise. Let's face it, EA dropped the ball with not only Battlefront 2, but also Battlefield 5. I personally never played it, but I did keep up with a lot of the controversy, including the reduction for the time to kill that happened in one of the earlier updates that kinda sent the community into overdrive. If you look at GamStat's page for Battlefield 5, you see that it pales in comparison to Battlefront 2. In fact, the numbers are virtually 50% of what Battlefront 2's numbers are. This means that, right now at least, Battlefront 2 is twice as popular as Battlefield 5 is, and that's saying something, especially considering that Battlefield 5 had half the lifespan of Battlefront 2. Both their live services got cut at roughly the same time, but Battlefield 5 launched a full year after Battlefront 2 did. Between then and now, Battlefront 2's popularity has only gone up, whereas Battlefield 5's popularity has unfortunately gone down. Based on that fact alone, it seems a little bit backwards that they would cancel Battlefront 2 and not even mention a brand new Battlefront title, but go ahead and announce and put all hands on deck on a new Battlefield title. It's just a little bit backwards logic if you ask me. That's not to say that I think the Battlefield fans don't deserve a new game. I think they absolutely do, especially after EA botched Battlefield 5. You guys absolutely deserve a new title that is actually good and fun to play. I just don't think that it should come at the expense of another successful franchise, and that's exactly what EA is doing. In my mind, it makes far more sense to put most hands on deck on the new Battlefield game and keep a skeleton crew or hire some more people to go to the Battlefront 2 side of things over at DICE and keep pumping out content for that game, even if it's smaller updates that don't come as frequently. I think that would go a long way in showing that EA sees Battlefront and specifically the Star Wars IP as much more than just a quick cash grab. Because what they've done with the Celebration Edition and basically putting Battlefront 2 out for free kinda gives us the impression that they only see Battlefront and Star Wars as a quick moneymaker. As I brought up before, the best case scenario is that EA is testing the waters. They put Battlefront 2 out for free, they're gonna see how many people upgrade to the Celebration Edition, and they'll see, based on that, if additional DLC will be justified. That's my hypothesis, my best case scenario theory. I'm not saying that's actually happening. What's more likely, and what is probably actually happening, is that EA put Battlefront 2 out for free knowing that it was popular, and knowing that a lot of people would download it. They then tease players even on the main menu with an upgrade to the Celebration Edition, and their only plan is to just rake in all the cash they get from the upgrades. They're not even thinking about future DLC. They just want to see how much more money they can squeeze out of this title before completely burying it 6 feet under. That's EA's style. That's their MO. Just see how much money they can rake in and then concentrate on the next big thing that they can make even more money off of. So this is probably the likely scenario, and I'm not saying that we will get DLC in the future. All I'm saying is that 3 million players in less than a month is a crazy number, especially for a game that is 2.5 years old. It shows people care about it, people want more, and people enjoy it. Hopefully this will open EA's eyes too, and show them that, yeah, Battlefront is a profitable franchise, and with some actual care and dedication, true dedication, not fake dedication just to save face, I think they can turn Battlefront into a serious moneymaker that can be a flagship franchise for not only DICE, but also EA as a whole. This is Star Wars we're talking about after all. The only limit is Lucasfilm's imagination, and there is so much content in Star Wars lore, you could essentially add Battlefront DLC until the end of time. That's not a joke, that's actual reality. You could do that if you had the resources and the desire to. EA's got the resources. I'm just hoping that they eventually develop the desire to go back to it. I think I've said enough on this piece though. This started as a different kind of video, but kind of just turned into a rant. I hope you guys don't mind the more unofficial approach to this one. If you guys like this style of video, let me know in the comments below, and maybe I'll do more in the future. Before you go, drop a comment below and let me know your thoughts on all of this stuff. Do you think Battlefront 2 should continue, or do you think 2.5 years of content updates is enough and we should just move on to the next big thing? Be sure to give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, give it a thumbs down if you didn't. Either way, consider subscribing if you're new, and that's going to do it from me. I appreciate you all stopping by the bazaar, and I will see you out on the battlefront. Peace.